And now we look at the limits to what President Biden can do about these supply and delivery issues and the effect it is having on the broader economy. David Lynch has covered this extensively for The Washington Post, and he joins me now. David Lynch, welcome back to the NewsHour. I know you listened today to what President Biden had to say. You were listening just now to Secretary Raimondo. How much difference do you think these moves that the administration's announcing to try to break up this bottleneck on the supply chain, how much difference is that going to make?
Well, I think it is a step in the right direction. At the margin, it may improve what's been a very difficult situation. But it's not entirely accurate to say that the Port of Long Beach has already gone 24/7. In fact, they have six container terminals at that port. Only one of the six has lengthened its hours in a pilot program. And at that, that terminal is open 24 hours Monday through Thursday. So not quite 24/7, and that leaves five other terminals out of it completely. At the Port of Los Angeles, which is the new initiative that was announced today, it's not clear yet how many of their terminals will go 24/7 and just what the operational details will be. So we're still waiting to hear on that. The problem, I think, you know, for the administration is that this is really a challenge that's not immediately amenable to federal power. The entire supply chain is composed of private sector companies, all independent, all operating sometimes in a very siloed way. And so the administration, and I think they've acknowledged this, recognizes that they can play a role of sort of convening and getting people together and jawboning them to cooperate and share data. But it's not as simple as, you know, cutting taxes or increasing spending. This, in many ways, is beyond the government's immediate power.
Well, we heard, in fact, I read some of the reporting you've done on just what you were talking about, and I did ask Secretary Raimondo, you know, what about the fact that the ports may not be fully 24/7? She said, we're working on those details. So they say they're doing that, but we also heard her say that it is up to the private sector. And we heard President Biden say, we're going to call them out if they don't step up. So what does that exactly mean? Does the private sector feel that kind of pressure from a president?
I think they do and they don't. I mean, it's a very fragmented system. So, you know, even the people directing the ports, say in Los Angeles and Long Beach, they can't order the terminals to stay open until 3 o'clock in the morning because those ports operate really just as landlords. And so the terminals set their own hours. And in the past, when there have been these night and pre-dawn hours available, truckers often won't show up because if you think about it, you know, if you're a trucker, you can show up at 3 a.m. to collect a shipping container, but then where are you going to go with it? The warehouse may be a half an hour away or 45 minutes away. They're not open at 3 a.m. So it really is essential. And obviously the administration officials involved with this understand this, but getting one part of the operation to longer hours will help, but only if everybody is part of that process. And it's going to take some time to make that happen, I think.
And I'm asking you about these details because this problem, as we now know, is affecting so many Americans, and whether they're waiting to remodel their house or they're waiting for something that they ordered that hasn't arrived. And I'm still trying to get at this question of how much difference can the administration, I guess you can call it jawboning, how much difference can that make, coupled with the moves that they say they have the ports making on their own?
I mean, you know, I think at the margin, the administration can help, and I think they're trying to help. I think they're also trying to look as if they're engaged and trying to help, because this is a problem that's not just an economic problem. It's a political problem, and Secretary Raimondo acknowledged that. You know, this is sort of the kind of Main Street economic problem that can really cause a president problems. Every person I talk to in my neighborhood, has got a story to tell about something they went out to buy at the store and couldn't find. I was waiting on a garden variety auto part that should have taken 2 days under normal circumstances. It took me 3 weeks. My wife constantly complains she can't find the specific type of cat food right. our incredibly fussy cat prefers. Now, none of these problems in and of themselves are fatal or showstoppers, but as they accumulate, they become, along with inflation, the kind of economic problem that any White House is going to be really concerned about.
And just in a word, we heard Secretary Raimondo say people will see a difference by Christmas. Do you believe that?
It's possible. I mean, these problems aren't going away by Christmas. Most of the people we spoke to for our recent project on the supply chain say we've got another year of disruption ahead of us. And one reason for that is in the middle of next year, the big contract with the longshoremen union out on the West Coast expires. And so a lot of companies that have already been having trouble getting their goods are starting to place precautionary orders for next year because they don't want to get caught short if there's some kind of labor action on the docks in the middle of 2022.
David Lynch with The Washington Post, thank you very much.